Yes. Okay, let's talk about witnesses then. We heard that in our passage this evening from the Acts of the Apostles. This, of course, being Easter time, is the time to read the Acts of the Apostles. Estábamos escuchando a los Hechos de los Apóstoles y durante este tiempo de Pascua es el tiempo más especial que todo para leer los Hechos de los Apóstoles, porque los Hechos de los Apóstoles es los primeros pasos de la iglesia en su infancia. The Acts of the Apostles tell us the first steps of the church in its infancy. And the thing that we hear about is witnesses. La cosa que dices los Hechos de los Apóstoles es testigos. Porque Jesús quiere mandar a sus discípulos, después de recibir el Espíritu Santo, quiere mandar a ellos a Jerusalén, a Judea, a Samaria y hasta el fin del mundo, que es Stillwater, Oklahoma, ¿verdad? Because what Jesus wants to do is to send his disciples out after they have received the Holy Spirit, to send them out to Jerusalem, to Judea, to Samaria, and then to the ends of the world, which is Stillwater, Oklahoma. That's where we finally got here. Entonces, nosotros somos discípulos porque hemos estado bautizados y creemos que Cristo es el Salvador y que Él nos ha dado su iglesia. Entonces, debemos estar testigos por el mundo, pero para hacerlo necesitamos el Espíritu Santo, ¿verdad? We should be those witnesses. We have been baptized into Christ. We believe that Jesus is Lord. He has given us his church. So we should be those ones, those disciples of his, who want to go into the world to be his witnesses to others. But for that, we need the gift of the Holy Spirit. St. Paul tells us that no one can say Jesus is Lord except in the Holy Spirit. San Pablo nos dice, pues San Pablo, ¿verdad?, con su espalda. San Pablo nos dice que nadie puede decir que Jesús es el Señor a menos que está en el Espíritu Santo. ¿Por qué es eso? Porque nadie va a creer. A menos que vivimos en el Espíritu Santo, nadie va a creernos. The reason why we have to receive the Holy Spirit to be his witnesses is because no one will believe us. If we don't live in the Spirit, if we don't live as disciples of the Lord, if we just say Jesus is Lord to people out there, but we don't live it, who's going to believe us, right? It would be worse. It'd be better if we didn't say anything. Because if we say Jesus is Lord, but we live the opposite, people will get the opposite message, right? Pero cuando estamos listos para vivir la fe, para pedir al Espíritu Santo cada día en nuestra vida, y después eso, testigamos a Jesús como el Señor, pues el Espíritu Santo va a poner sus semillas en el mundo. But if we will live the faith and then witness to people, calling on the Holy Spirit every day, then the Holy Spirit will plant his own seeds in the world around us. And then others will come to faith. So that's why we want you to receive the Holy Spirit this evening through this gift of the sacrament of confirmation. But think of it this way. If I introduce you to someone new this evening, some new person, and you say, hello, how are you? Nice dress. And then you go home and you forget their name, and you never text them or anything, then nothing will happen. There won't be any kind of relationship. You won't have a friendship. There won't be any power there. It's only if I introduce you to someone and you say, hey, nice to meet you. I'd like to get to know you. That's when something powerful begins to happen. Y lo mismo es con el Espíritu Santo. Si nos conoce el Espíritu Santo esta noche por este sacramento, pero mañana olvidamos que hemos recibido. Si no hablamos con el Espíritu Santo, nunca llamamos al Espíritu Santo en nuestra vida, ¿Cómo puede Él compartir con nosotros su poder? No puede, ¿verdad? Porque no estamos abiertos. Es solamente si cuando estamos abiertos al Espíritu Santo que Él puede pasar a nosotros su poder. Ustedes han estudiado los regalos del Espíritu Santo, los frutos del Espíritu Santo, pero no podemos recibirlos si no hablamos del Espíritu Santo, ¿verdad? You've studied about the gifts and the fruits of the Holy Spirit, but we can't receive them if we don't talk to Him. Cada día puede despertar con la idea que el Espíritu Santo, ayúdame este día a reconocer las oportunidades a testificar a Cristo este día. Y Él va a ayudarle. Every day you can wake up with this prayer, this thought in your mind. Holy Spirit, today, help me to recognize those opportunities that you place before me to witness to Jesus, who is the Lord. And He will do that. He will help you. And then you'll find yourself doing odd things, talking to people about your faith, inviting people to come to Mass with you. There's great cookies afterwards or something, I don't know. There's handsome people there, I don't know, whatever. And then people will come. And people will learn about the good news of the gospel, and they will come to faith with you.